Beautiful people, how you doing today? Okay, once again, it's Raf here on Explorers Media Technologies, and today we are still on Photoshop tutorial, and we will learn how to apply dodge and burn to our images. Now, I'd like to explain the meaning of the word dodge and burn. Okay, dodge and burn simply means it's a process of adjusting the exposure of a particular picture. Now, due to the kind of light setup we have for a particular picture when capturing an image, the light of the image can be different as compared to another one. So dodge and burn helps us to adjust the side of the image that has so much highlights and reduce it. And the side that has so much shadow can also be reduced. Now let me clearly explain what I mean. So if you go to your dodge and burn tool here, your dodge or burn tool, and you click at this pane, you will find three different things: the highlights, the mid-tone, and the shadows. Now the shadows are the darkest part of the image and the highlights are the brightest part of the image. For example, of a highlight here at this part, the hand here, this place could be seen as a highlight because it seems to be the brightest part of the image, and the shadows are darkest part, like the neck collarbone here, the collarbone here, this area is dark too, and the mid-tones are the light or the exposure that is in between the shadow and the highlight. For example, a place like this has it's in between, it's not too dark, it's not too bright. Just like the forehead here, it's not too dark, it's not too bright. So that is what dodge and burn actually means. So in the process of dodge and burning, you are actually making a highlight to be, you know, you're actually reducing the brightness or the exposure of a highlight, or increasing the exposure of a shadow. So now, how do we do that dodge and burn? Now that's the next step, and there's so many ways of doing dodge and burn, but I'm just going to show you the simplest step here. Now when I do my dodge and burn, at first I actually create two adjustment layers for my curves, and the first layer I name it dodge, and the second layer I name it burn. So now the second layer burn contains the shadows. When you're burning, you're actually making the image darker, and when you're dodging, you're actually making the image brighter. So for example, if I invert this layer mask on my burn layer, you see how dark the image will be. So this is the shadow that I've set it to be, so I can work with this. And if you do the same with the dodge, you see how bright it will become. So this is how bright the image will be. So when the two are blended together, we have an even brightness. So at the same time, what we can do here now is I haven't created your two layers. If you don't know how to create your adjustment layer, you can just come to this icon here, click on it, and you click on curves. When you click on curve, you can actually choose what you want. You want it bright or dark, as it suits you, depending on the image. I don't need to create any other one because I have created it already. So now in this case, now I'll say there are just basically two techniques to apply in the dodge and burn process. I'll show you both of them. Now it's good to note that not every picture should be dodged and burned here. So we just have to look out for an image. And one good thing about dodge and burn is if you're dodging and burning, it actually brings out the beauty of an image. I'll show you the before and after of this image when we're done, so you get to see what I mean. So now most times I do create a black and white layer so that they can clearly see the lighting of a particular image, because if the color is there, you might not be able to distinguish between the bright areas and the dark areas. But if it's black and white, you can actually do that clearly. So it's not a problem if you choose to use the black and white, just to create black and white layer, and that's just it. If you don't want to use it, you can still use it in a colored form, color layer. So now let's get straight to the point now. Okay, so now the aim here is to make sure that when I'm dodging, the end product will look like this, and when I'm burning, the end product will look like this. So that's what we're trying to do. So in this case, we use the brush tool, and we try to increase the size of the brush. Okay, so we just increase and reduce the size of the brush. Then you zoom into the image and look for the areas where you want to work on. So now the first method is your opacity should be at 100 and your flow of your brush tool should be at 100. Now you carefully, what you do is, let's start from the burn tool. Let's work on the dark areas. You carefully swipe through the dark areas, like the collarbone here. You do that and make sure that your brush, the hardness of your brush is set to 0 so that it can be smooth at this time. And okay, I think for now the collarbone is okay. And let's say we want to work on the jaw a bit and just more of that, a little bit of that, and somewhere here is fine. Now, okay, let's get to leave the jaw. Okay, we can work on this other side of the jaw. Yeah, fine. And we can let this side be. Now, at this time, if your opacity and your flow is at 100%, what you can do in order to make it look nice, you go to your Gaussian blur tool and you set it to a value of about 23. And when it's at 23, it becomes blurry, and the dodge or the burn that we have done will no longer be destructive to the image, but it will have a very definite pattern because it's blurred, so the edges are blurred. And we can see that if we want to make it more even, we can increase it a bit and see how it is. So 45 is good. Now if you look clearly, it has just brought out the collarbones, and the collarbones are now defined. This is the first method. So we can do the same to the dodging tool, and let's say we dodge this place and make it white, and here, okay. Then we apply our Gaussian blur again, and fine, we're good to go. So now let's turn off our dodge and burn layer, off, on, off, on. So now that's the beauty of dodge and burn. And this is just the first technique, and the second technique here is still on the adjustment layer. All you can do, you try your possible best. Okay, let me just revert what I have done, and okay, fine, we're good here. Let's take it backwards a bit. Okay, so now you try to reduce your opacity to about 16 and reduce your flow to about 16 or 17. 16 is fine. Then at this time, you carefully brush on the areas where you want to work on, carefully, and after a while, turn off the layer to see its visibility, and you turn it on so you can actually find the before and after. These are just two ways you can achieve the dodge and burn. Now, aside from using the curve adjustment layers, there are also layers adjustment that you could use. You can use your exposure, your level, or your brightness. Now the aim of all this is to make sure that we actually make the picture brighter or darker. So for me, the best tool I use is the curve adjustment layer, and it gives me what I want. So I believe you must have been able to learn something good from this dodge and burn tutorial. And I hope to see you in the next video. Do remember that dodge and burn is just a technique that can be used to adjust the lighting of an image, and just lighting of the subject, making the areas of the bright to become brighter or darker. And that's beauty to the image. And it can also be good for makeup. You know, when a makeup is there and you work on the makeup, and it become more beautiful. So that's just it. I think we'll stop here for now and see you in our next tutorial. Thank you.